gon' fuck with you, you gon' fuck with me, you gon' fuck with her, she gon' fuck with me. You get the cups, I get the drinks, you like survive, I do Hennessy. I wanna get in you, for I can do what he can do, cause you wind in the wave, cause I'm live and he's lame. So move a little closer and I might take it over. Dancing like we fucking and I don't give a fuck. I got you pretty lady, I got you feeling wavy. Music in my hands and my feet is to the beat. Let's get high, let's get drunk, let's do what we want. Let's get faded and wasted. So wild, imagine in the sheets. Get the Dutch, and I got the weed. She like my style and my melody. You want me to get in you, for I can do what he can do. Cause you wind in the wave, cause I'm live and he's lame. So move a little closer.
Crazy right here. We broke up with our new wife and everything. And I just want to run this up to 1,000 subscribers before we spill the tea. What really went down, my bad, is just like a crazy situation what just happened and how Raina got threw out in the street for no reason out in Atlanta while me and Sandy was in New York. And we're going to tell you what happened, especially from Raina, what happened. Long as y'all just run this shit up. God damn. I couldn't see it happening. Like, I didn't even believe it for my own eyes. It's crazy how Naomi will even portray herself like that. But it's all good. Run it up to 1,000 subscribers. And we got you full interview with Raina, me, and Sandy of what really went down. Holla at me.
Oh my God, ain't you the Monopoly guy?
Me, polygamy. Polygamy.
Whatever. I just hear that you can put me in a house and hopefully you get me some new boots. Can you help me out?
Oh, shit. What you got to bring to the table?
I'm an Instagram auntie, feel like Ashanti. Oh. Can you take me in? Please take me in. Please, I'm so cold right now. It's really cold. Can you help me? And it's so fun, too. Oh, my God. I just want to be a part of whatever it is that you do. God, dang, it's so fun.
To the place to restart the race. So while he is sleeping, I'm sitting up creeping, going in his pocket, cause I know he won't clock it. Racking up the dollars for the next creep who hollers. I get up in his head, take him to the bed. This is the story about how I make my bread, cause I'm the Instagram auntie. I'm built like a shanty. I only date rappers who want this punani. Talking about my age, but your baby daddy want me. I'm the number one gold digger. I ain't sexing with no broke jigger.
I knew it.
Why you didn't tell me if you knew?
I did tell you.
Like about her though, specifically?
I told you.
You told me about her specifically though.
Specifically.
The new wife.
Yeah, Naomi.
You told me about Naomi.
Yes, I did. So where you at now? Where you at? All I want to know.
Yo, son, I'm in New York. I've been in New York for like a few days.
I told you not to go there. I told you. You just didn't listen to me.
Yo, you know what she did to Raina?
I can imagine.
Yo, I thought she was perfectly fine. Like, I never had a problem with her. Like, what's wrong with her?
No, she was never fine. She was never fine.
What happened, yo? How you be seeing shit and you be reading people like, yo, that shit crazy, auntie?
I told you. I'm so glad you got back to New York. I told you.
But I've been in New York.
But
like,
here's the thing. Don't talk about her. You know what I'm saying? That's not cool.
I ain't gonna talk about her. You're right. That's not cool. But I'ma just, you feel me?
I'ma just
say the truth of what we went through.
You live and you learn. You live and you learn. Any situation that's too easy is not real. Remember that.
Any situation that's too easy is not real.
Right. If it's too easy, it's not real. Life is a struggle. Nothing you don't want. Nothing that's handed to you. Nothing. Struggle for everything you want in life. Everything. I'm telling you, you'll be better off.
You're right, and the thing is, like, when you ask somebody in your life, they problems become your problems, and we never had no problems. Like, you feel me? She had like a lot of debt. You feel
that's
me?
I'm not talking bad about the same house. You weren't in the same house. Of course, everything gonna be nice. Come on now, you got to watch out for people that wake up with an attitude. You got to watch out for people that just wake up grumpy. I'm not talking about her.
So, right.
I'm saying you got to watch out. You got to watch the energy of people. You know what I'm saying? Seriously.
Right.
The energy. I was like, why did he go to another state? That's why I asked you that question. You know the question I asked you?
When she came over here, we treated her with nothing but love. You feel me?
But you went into her space.
Yeah. So she was like, oh, you know, she was like, yo, when I was in New York, y'all treat me with nothing but love. So when y'all over here, you're gonna get love back. Like, I don't care.
Come on, Wavey.
Where's the love?
Wavey.
How was that love? That's not
Wavey.
Love.
Come on, Wavey. Well, come on, Wavey. You 20, 28, 20, how old are you?
27.
All right, you 27 now. Come on now. You don't know how women get when you get in their space? You don't know that?
Like,
yes or no? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay, so you live and you learn. It's a good
but
thing.
But it was a plan though, like. You feel me?
A plan? A plan doesn't change a person. A plan hides a person for their true colors. Come on now. You know. Look at me. Look at my glasses. Come on now. A plan? Look where a plan got me. You understand what I'm saying? And this ain't this real life. This is real life for you too, but me too. Look where it got me. You put your energy into, like, In a way, you're trying to help somebody else be themselves. You know what I'm saying? Like, show your real color. You know, this what you like. This what you into. I'm going to help you be that. And then you, like, get me in a spot where you think I need you. And then say,
nah, it's not where I need. She needed us because she was backed up on rent. Not to talk shit about her, but she was getting evicted. That's why me and Sandy came to New York. So we could come up with that. You feel me?
Listen. What? All right. You want to talk about it? What did she do? What's up, D Blacks? What did she do?
Yo, for no reason. When we left, like, how long we been in New York?
Like a whole week.
A whole week.
Today we make a whole week.
I bet, cause I didn't sleep. You feel me? I be losing track on days. All right. So we been here for a whole week. Before we left, it's perfectly fine. Her family wasn't helping her. She had mad bills. Her family been helping her, like, from time to time, but not like that. You feel me? Not to talk shit about her, but I'm just saying, like, this is a struggle. Like, they had, like, pit bulls in the garage. It was mad full of shit. So the whole house smelled like shit. No funny shit. So they had to clean
that
out.
What did she do, Wavey? Not to talk
about
her.
The next, she do lashes.
No, what did she do?
She threw Raina out for no reason.
Okay, so that's my point. That's what I'm saying. Forget all the stinky shit and all that stuff. That's my point. You were in her space, and she let it be known. When you first got there, I said, oh, boy, this is going to go sour. Why in the hell did he go all the way to Georgia? I saw the whole thing.
Yo, but when even she could tell you when she was in New York, like,
stop,
we showed her nothing,
Wavey,
but love.
Wavey, like, stop saying that. Wavey, seriously, listen to me. Stop saying that part, because that's why I tell people, never do nothing for people expecting something in return. Because
New
human
York
beings
crying right now, look.
Human beings don't work like that. Human beings don't work like, they don't give a shit what you do to them. Do for them. It doesn't matter to people. She doesn't care about that. You understand what I'm saying?
I feel you, auntie.
So, I mean, for you, I see if she was in New Jersey, somewhere close by, for you to make a move like that. That's why I asked you the question I asked you, because why would you go, what, 11 hours away from your home and trust this girl just because you've been interacting with her over the phone?
But she came over here first. That's what I'm saying.
That doesn't matter, Wavey. That, she set you up. That's a plot. That's a plot. That's just like a girl getting pregnant and telling you, marry her. She going to have your baby and be faithful to you for the rest of her life. And then next thing you know, she cheating with your homeboy. That's what that's like. You better open your eyes.
Thank you.
I'm serious. I knew it from the get-go. Eventually, she would have wanted to be Sandy, take Sandy's position in that house.
That's a fact, auntie, yo.
I know. I saw it from the day one. I'm like, why is she acting like she all in love like that? You ain't the queen.
She said you ain't the queen.
I'm serious, but I shut up and I went home and the bitch probably got my fucking gloves. I'm mad now. I'm kicking her ass. Let me stop. She ain't no bitch, though. I don't say bitch. But seriously, my gloves missing, though. She probably got my gloves.
And you know what the thing is? Like, she had a family. It was her and her family that did that. And then she's saying that her family made her do that. And then she was crying. And then she wanted to kill herself.
Yeah, she ain't killing herself. She looking for the next dude. She ain't killing herself. Trust me. Wavey.
Yeah.
You know I like to joke. I'm a comedian, right? You know
that's
that,
a
right?
fact. That's a fact.
Right.
I guess it's New York versus Atlanta now. I declare war. No Atlanta niggas could come perform in New York at all, my nigga, because we're going to pull up with some shit they never seen. Like, some real shit. I'm clout chasing. Watch. I'm going to really go pull up on these Atlanta niggas with cameras, with mad niggas, no lack. And then we gonna fuck up this show. Like, you gotta end it. Party over. Come outside, pussy. Come outside. Fuck niggas talking about.
Wait a minute. That girl said you and your wife treated her like shit.
What? She can't say that. She can't even say that out of her own mouth. The person you talking about can't even say that.
Who said what? Who said what?
Said you treat her like shit.
That is a lie.
You gotta think about. You gotta think about this ahead of time, like all this backlashing and all that stuff. You know what I mean?
We didn't even get a clue that she was like that.
Three sides to every story. That's funny. More than two sides. That's funny.
It's actually seven sides to every story. So what are you talking about? The seven sides.
Why did he call her Dora?
Who's calling who Dora?
They calling that girl Dora.
No, I'm Dora.
You're Dora?
She's Dora.
Yeah, that's what Robert calls me.
Oh, okay. All right. I'm like, who's Dora?
She's Dora. You call her Raina, Dora, like whatever you want to call her. She's adorable.
My name is Raina.
My name Raina.
I got you. I'm like Dora. What the hell? She had some shit on her IG Live surviving crazy.
What? He's about to put out mad false information. That shit is hilarious.
Don't feel bad.
You know what's crazy? Because they got some shit called Surviving Nature Boy. Like, this shit crazy.
Wavey, don't.
Why they want to put me in that category, man?
Well, don't. Wavey.
Why they want to put me in the category, though? That's all I'm saying. I'm not in this fucking category.
Wait a minute, Wavey.
He not in my lead. He ain't my fucking lane.
Don't feel bad because they did one on me called Surviving Auntie Kelly.
For real? Damn.
People stupid. That might be one of her family members typing this right now, saying this, so promoting her.
She's a fan.
Nah, I fucks with her. She said, go check it out.
That's a shame. She clout chased off you this whole time. That's what that means. If she did that already, come on, it hadn't even been 24 hours. She clout chased off of you. She got you for real. She punks you for real. For real. She got you good. If she's so suicidal and going through all of this stuff and she did put all that together that fast, she punks your ass for real. She punks.
Let me see my phone.
Damn, Wavey, you slipping, Wavey.
I'm slipping, but why was she? This is her before she came out with that. This is her before she came out with that. Look, like, y'all gotta. You're not taking no pills.
He's first. He's gonna come back. I had to do a restart.
You like people to do that for you, so you can have clout. So what I'm gonna do is record what I'm saying right now. Wavey P, Willie, I'm gonna take a look at these pills right now. Let me record it.
Yo, babe, stop.
Let me record it. See if that's what you like.
Yo, FaceTime me. You're lying.
This show is
going to
be the show of
yo,
your life.
Yo, can you choke? Yo.
This is going to be the clout that you wanted, right? This is the clout that you wanted.
Why you want to do that to yourself?
I'm
going to
record this shit with a pill, babe.
Babe, chill.
I'm going to record this shit right here. You hear me? People believe me, and even after the fact, you're going to be responsible for my death. You know that, right? When I can't give it to me, you know that, right?
You're not taking no pills. I'm not being responsible for no death.
Yo, to make it even better, I'm just going to record it, send it to you so you can post it on your page, so you can brag about it. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what you like people to do that for you, so you can have clout. So what I'm going to do is record what I'm saying right now. Wavey P, Willie, I'm going to take a look at these pills right now. Let me record it.
Yo, babe, stop.
Let me record it. See if that's what you like.
Yo, FaceTime me. You're lying.
This show is going to be the show of your life.
Yo, can you choke? Can you? Yo.
This is going to be the clout that you wanted, right? This is the clout that you wanted.
Why you want to do that to yourself?
Record me. I'm going to record this shit with a pill,
babe. Babe, chill.
I'm going to record this shit you meet, even after the fact, you're gonna.
Good morning, everybody. So, she done put that together that fast. Did you see it yet?
Nah, I didn't see it. I'm not even gonna look at it. Like, why even? I'm not gonna.
You're gonna be one extra view, right?
I'm not just like focus on that. That's not where my head is at. Like.
Sorry, Wavey. Sorry, I'm sorry. I'm poor Wavey. Poor Wavey.
It's all good. I trained her very well.
You live and you learn, right? You know that just sounds like a bunch of Charlie Brown. That's not clear. Wavey.
It's not clear?
No.
Nah, she was saying I was going to be responsible for her death. And all
when did
that.
She say that?
Huh?
That's a voicemail she left?
Nah, we was on the phone call and I recorded it so people won't think like I'm playing. So
can
I
you
went.
Do that?
Did I do what?
Can you record? Is that legal?
Record a phone conversation?
Yeah.
I mean, it's already being recorded by the FBI, so why not?
But I'm saying, like, this is proof. Yeah, you could record a phone conversation. Like, everybody record phone conversations. When you call the bank, they record. When you call any company, a soda company, like, anything, like, whatever, they record the conversations. Like,
yeah, but hold off on playing that. Hold off on playing that, though.
I ain't playing that.
I'm talking about playing it. Hold off on that, because I don't know if that... I think that you have to... Yeah, hold off on that one. You know what I'm saying? Because you don't know how far people that's desperate for money will go. You know what I'm saying? You don't know how far this can go. She's not suicidal if she's doing a surviving Wavey video that fast.
She's clout chasing off his
yeah,
head.
That's what it sounds like. That this was all clout chasing Wavey. And you know what? People do it to me all the time. So you live and you learn. People do it to me for months at a time. Pretend to be my friend. They're not really my friend. But then people are like, who are you? Why would somebody clout chase off of you? I'm the Instagram auntie. I'm built like Ashanti. That's who I am. So people use who they can use. He was laughing with her cousin. Wavey, you see that? Wavey.
What?
He was laughing with her cousin, but yes, she's saying she's suicidal. Yeah, Wavey, it's a dub. Just break ties with her and don't reconnect. That's all I can tell you.
Crazy.
And at least it wasn't like a year, a whole year, something like that. You got yourself mixed up in this.
Nah, it was like a month for all of us, a month and a half. You feel me?
Yeah.
Shit, crazy.
Doing what I love got all the tea. You just not looking at what you're typing. Yeah, exactly. Move on. Don't even bash her. You did the diss track. That's good enough. Don't even bash her.
I didn't even want to do the diss track. You made me do the diss track.
Yeah, I made you.
You was like, do the diss track. Y'all could go
because
back.
I knew she was doing it to you. I knew she was doing it to you. That's why.
She's doing the diss track.
I knew she wasn't somewhere crying. Suicidal. I knew she was doing it to you. And look, your follower proved it to be right.
Proved it to be right. God damn.
Yeah. She just wanted somebody to pay her bills. No love. That wasn't love.
I was out of line, auntie. I ain't do nothing wrong to her. You feel me? Like, we just treated her with nothing but love.
Yeah.
To be honest with you, like, she a bug out. She a real bug out. Like, she want to support this nigga. You know, the nigga that said his son plays with his dick and all that?
I think they said that she went back to following him. Somebody typed that in the
yeah, comments. Yeah, so that's crazy. Let's see how far she'll take it. Like, I think she'll take, yo, is she spreading something? Like, what is, I don't know. I'm questioning right now, like.
Oh, they talking about, she's bragging about throwing Raina out.
That's crazy. That's fucked up. And Raina ain't do nothing to her.
Immortal Naomi is her new name.
Yeah.
We can't make this shit up. That's all I can tell you.
It's all good. But you know me, though. No.
So she wanted this nature boy in the first place.
Huh?
So she wanted Nature Boy in the beginning.
Yeah, she found me off his love.
Oh, so you was a substitute. She used you. Oh my God, how do you feel?
I feel good. Like I don't live wrong. I didn't do nothing wrong to her. So I just feel like, damn, that's fucked up how people walk.
You don't feel violated at all?
Yeah, a little bit.
All right, we appreciate your honesty. That's where we were trying to get to. We wanted you to be honest. You know what I mean?
I feel a little violated.
Yeah, you look like you feel violated.
I do.
You look like you feel so violated. You look like you squeezing your butt cheeks together. Right?
Crazy, auntie.
Now, I'm just telling you, you look like you're feeling tight, like constipated, violated.
Yo, you crazy.
What? You got that? I'm squeezing my butt cheeks so the shit won't fall out. Look on your face.
Damn, auntie. Wow, auntie, like that's fucked up.
I would feel like that too. Look at that, punk.
This shit is unbelievable.
Yeah. They saying he gonna get up back though. He gonna get up back for what she did to you.
He gonna get her back for what she did to me?
Yeah, they saying karma gonna get her.
That's what's up. So I hope Nature Boy use her for clout.
How can he use her for clout?
Like, he try to get back at me like I did with Ra. So he's gonna take her, use her, and then send her back.
Yo, wow.
Raina right here.
They said we all gonna get her back. Kristen, what's up with your other account? So if we were to come up with a round figure, how much money do you think you invested in her?
Hey, when it comes to food, weed, what else? We went out, the toes done, all that little stuff. I don't know. Probably like 500.
But what about the relocation process? There was some money involved in that, right? The travel?
Yeah, probably like $1,000.
Oh, that's not bad, then. Not bad at all.
Oh, we paid her light bill. My bad. So it's probably like $1,200. And what else? Raina saying a little bit like 1500, 1600.
I'm getting up there in the numbers now.
Man, we didn't even think about that. Wow, man. Wow. Wow. This is crazy, man. It's all right. Like, everything gonna be good. It's not a big deal for me. Like, you just gotta relax. Raina's good. Everybody happy. The entertainment still go on. Like, she's doing all this. Like, it's even better than what I thought right now would be. So I appreciate it's even going down like this. I like how it's going down. I'm loving the energy and the air and the atmosphere. I like how that all plays out. You feel me? She don't got nothing on me. We treated her right. What she gonna have on me?
Good.
Like, we ain't do nothing. We don't live wrong. We don't. Can't say nothing. What she gonna say?
Who is Eli Go? Who's that? Eli
that's
Go?
That's the guy that had his son play with his meat and in the tranny porn, and he likes trannies and
that's
and
his name? That's his name?
Eligio, yeah.
And what else do you call him? Immortal Chief?
That's his Instagram.
Oh, shoot.
The nigga, like, saying that he let his son touch his meat and all that with all these women manipulating them, and it's just crazy. And she know this. That girl, Naomi, that's proof to show you that these girls are still dishonorable as women and queens for being with a dick-sucking-ass nigga. Because once a nigga is in your asshole, you don't got no manhood no more.
Hold on.
You sold your soul. Once a nigga's in your asshole, you sold your soul. No manhood. Your manhood is gone, my nigga. You got nothing. And these women know that he likes watching tranny porn, my nigga. So look, the woman is fucked up mentally. Ain't no coming back. He sold his soul already. He sucked the dick. He likes
Wavey. I gotta go.
The picture, this infamous picture y'all talking about, right? Was a picture that I took for myself.
For me, when I was in jail. This is why
when he was locked
even,
up. You guys want to see
the
picture?
This is why the pictures was even created. Because when I was locked up,
I'll show you the pictures.
I need those pictures for my wives when I was locked up for impersonating a police officer. I needed those pictures. But let me get them.
I'll show you the pictures.
Nah.
I'll show you it. Pictures.
Where are the other pictures at? When I was locked up.
Nah, these are just regular pictures of me.
Oh.
Pictures. The fuck?
I go through my old mail and shit. Y'all talking about this? Look.
You might as well show this since it's already out to the fucking world.
No, I don't want you to get blocked.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I forgot. Damn.
Now had to step out and tune in and wanted to ask you a couple questions, you know, because, you know, I did hear both sides or a little bit of, you know, her side. And, you know, for me, as of what I'm doing in my reality, you know, I have a certain code that I live by. You know what I mean? Is I judge you by how you treat your woman. You know what I mean? So for this girl to come out and say that, you know what I mean? Now I'm looking at you with a slightly different lens. You know what I mean? So now I want to ask you specific questions to see, you know what I mean, if the truth stands up, you know?
Right.
All right. So let's get your side of the story, right? So how long did y'all know each other?
I met her off Chief Live a month and a half ago. Like, we started talking a month and a half ago after she found me off of Chief Live after confronting him.
Okay. Right. So how long were you actually in, like, physical relationship? Like when did you...
Not even... But physical relationship, I flew her out from Atlanta to New York December 20th. We all went together back to Atlanta December 6th. January 6th, my bad. And me and Sandy left Atlanta a week ago. So we was physically together, like in person, in the physical form, me and Sandy, for about two and a half weeks, and Raina 3 weeks, almost 4 weeks.
Okay.
So it was just, Raina was there with her in Atlanta, and she threw Raina's shit out for no reason, and she's trying to make it seem it wasn't her fault and stuff like that, when she was the one that really, like, physically threw her shit out, my fur coat out in the street, and never.
Check out homeboy. See, I'm the brother out there, huh?
Look at the fish in his shoes. Girl, he must be a rock star.
The brother's walking on an aquarium.
Say, brother, do you get nosebleeds?
Maybe it's his dinner.
Hey, homie, you expecting a blow?
So my question is, why would y'all trust her when y'all barely even know her? Like when you think y'all would spend a little bit more time or she would show a little bit more loyalty first before you can, you know, send your queens down there with her to a state that you don't know that well?
I mean, when she came, like, we was talking about building and polygamy and uplifting each other, and she was speaking real spiritual stuff, and, you know, like spiritual growth stuff. She's smart, but we didn't know that these smart people, we didn't know that they could be like this crazy. Like, she's a Nature Boy follower. She's putting Nature Boy up on her stories, and after I done exposed her right next to her, she done exposed them too. Like, yo, they all gay in there, so why is you going back to him, even though you know they he's gay? Why are you going back to him for? So I feel like she infiltrated. She's very at the lowest point of her life right now because she's backed up on her rent and there's nobody that could help her with the $3,000-$4,000, and she's about to get evicted. The only people that could have helped her was us. That's why me and Sandy in New York. You feel me? So it was just she crazy. She told us about her past. She told us about her family problem. She told us she got exposed for prostitution before. She told us that her family found out about her past about prostitution. You feel me? She tried to bring that prostitution light onto us. And we don't, she tried to, like, only fan pages and stuff like that. We don't, I'm not gonna make an only fan page so people could see my wives and pay to see. Like, we that's like a degrade to women, you feel me? She tried to like, oh, y'all should do OnlyFans. Look at these websites and stuff like that. You could send people pictures for money. She got a guy that she send pictures of her feet and she be sending
question.
Her. Yeah.
Do you think that she was trying? Okay, so before we get into that, do you feel like she came in with a agenda prior, like a premeditated agenda? Like, do you think Nature Boy and her cooked something up, you know, in a lab, like an agenda to come, like get you with to make you fall?
Yeah, but I thought about that, but when she got on that plane, those worries, like, I'm like, she got on the plane.
So her acting basically crystallized it for you. Her action basically showed her that, okay, so she really down, and she really down for, like, my, you know, like what we're trying to build here and like what we're trying to do. So, like, basically her actions, like crystallized it for you is what you're saying.
Like, yeah, when she came to on that plane and she came all the way from Atlanta by herself, that made me think, like, she wasn't capping no more. She wasn't trolling anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me?
Yes.
I was like, I thought she could have been a troll. I thought she could have been, like, somebody trying to be sneaky or something like that about me. I thought, but after she got on that plane, I'm like, oh, and after we had sex and everything, and after we just loving each other, we treating each other right. Like, it was nothing she could say that we treated her wrong. I never had an argument with her, bro. Before me and Sandy left to Atlanta, my queen,
yeah,
we was fine. We had an agreement. We was gonna come back and help her save the rent, even if she had to go to court and us come up with the whole money by then. That should be enough time. Like, we had a plan. We never had an argument. That's the crazy thing. We had an understanding. She was a spiritual intellectual, but she's fucking crazy, bro.
See, and I'm just trying to develop my own perspective, because I know everybody can push their own narrative and things like that, because we can't physically see what happened inside y'all's relationship, you know what I mean? So we can only see what y'all tell us. So we're trying to piece the story together with the behaviors, with the traits and attributes that y'all possess, and we're trying to, you know, understand it from our own perspective. So my question is, were there any red flags or anything that you noticed?
Matter of fact, finish your question. My bad. She would joke around and be like, Elysia, Elysia, Elysia. I'm be like, what the fuck is wrong with you, right, Raina?
Mm-hmm.
She would be like, Elysia. I'm like, stop playing with me. Like, stop fucking playing with me. Stop saying that shit. And I think she was playing too much. She's really crazy. And like, he got some works on her, bro.
Well, okay, so I want to ask a question that the people think. So basically she's saying, right, that y'all are like an escort service, right? Or something like that, right? That's what she's trying to say, right?
She took the pictures that...
Yeah, Raina, basically, that's what she's trying to say.
So my thing is, you said earlier that she was trying to show you how to do, like, the Snapchat private, the Instagram private, like, all these websites and things like that. Do you think that she was trying to get y'all onto the plan? Because is to get y'all started so she can, you know, have the receipt to say this?
We don't know what her intentions was, to be honest, because I can't sit here and tell you, like, oh yeah, she was plotting against us, because I'm not inside her brain, so I don't know how she really functions. You get what I'm saying? So I can't really answer that question. The only person that could really answer that question is her.
But were there any that's what I'm trying to see, like, were there any behaviors, were there anything that y'all noticed that was odd, that wasn't normal, that was...
There was, you know, nothing. It was perfectly fine harmony. We never had an argument. If we do have an argument, we putting that shit on live, bro, because we want people to see the real problems and the real issues about polygamy. Because we never... Yo, we talk like normal human beings. Like, if we have a disagreement about... What's the disagreement about? Like, why is there a disagreement? Well, about what? What? We had it all... Like, everything straight down the line, understanding and expectations and standards and stuff like that down the line. It's certain things we do, certain things we don't do. You feel me? So it was no reason for her to...
I think the people would... I think the people would feel better or have a better understanding if they knew a little bit more of, like, what's your purpose? Like, what are you trying to create? Like, what's your plan? Like, I know you don't want to spill the beans and everything like that, but, like, do you have, like, an image of what your future, like, what your self, is going to do in life, you know? So that people can see that, like, what are you trying to build? Like, are you going to build an empire? Are you trying to, like what?
I'm trying to build all of us. You feel me? I'm trying to build all of us, even, like, good people, you know, pure-hearted people, people like us. Not no, like, we didn't treat her wrong. We didn't, like, we good people. This is how polygamy is supposed to be. I just want people that's going to try polygamy, they got to be real careful and make sure y'all get to know the person for long enough, even for at least 6 months before meeting them in person. Like,
I think if we're in a court of law, you know, and if there's no physical evidence or video of y'all, you know, of y'all actually saying all the, you know, of y'all actually doing what she's saying, right? Just her being in Nature Boy's camp prior to the relationship and then now so quickly after leaving, now changing her name to Immortal and posting those photos, I think that, you know, kinds of, you know, if we were in a court of law, like, that would definitely impact the jurors heavily, you know what I mean? Because we don't have any photo evidence of you, you know, sex trafficking your wives outside those pictures, but it's like, what couple doesn't take pictures of them? You know, like, come on, like, be real. Like, we've all seen,
when I was impersonating a police officer, I needed those pictures, bro. I needed those pictures.
Before you continue anything, Pamela Rubia, this is my life, right? Can I block her or something? Cause this shorty right here. How I do that?
I love. Boom.
How she was talking shit with this no name girl, and she wanna be on my live on my bananas? Like, bro, hop off me. You was just talking shit about me with her, right? Pretending to be my sister, right?
Wow. Yeah, so she made a fake conversation. You know how Robert made a fake conversation? This is why I do what I do and do my skits, so people could be aware of how people could fake receipts, like me and Robert fake receipts, right or wrong? Me and Robert fake receipts, my nigga. So she created, Robert was texting himself. Even we DM Robert if Robert needed, like, some shit to understand. Yeah, and I'm like, oh, this and that and the third. Not no crazy shit, though. Just enough so people could be questioning.
On some real king shit, though. You know, like, you know, we all send, you know, photos to each other. You know, we all send intimate photos to each other when we're in those personal relationships. So, having, you know, like, we all have those photos on our phones and our locked apps and whatever we have, you know what I mean? So let's not act like we're all holy and sanctified and things like that, you know? So she could have grabbed some of them photos and posted them, you know, while they were sleeping or something like that.
Wake up. This is why my purpose is for people to really wake up, like, above that combination shit. People could sound intellectual but really be sick fucks, bro.
But we also gotta keep, like, if there's any video evidence or any photo evidence that she has that comes out that sways the public, you have to understand
I got photo evidence of her saying she's gonna kill herself, of her saying that she's gonna swallow a whole bottle of pills, bro.
Okay, yeah, but like,
she's mentally fucked up, but
that's serious, but like, you know, like that stuff might need to go to the police and things like that. You know what I mean? But
you want to know how crazy she is? Before she came out with all of this, whatever she came out with, the escort thing or whatever, she literally FaceTimed him. So this is how it all happened. Like, she was crying, whatever the fuck she was wanting to do. She FaceTimed him, saying whatever she was going to do with the pills or whatnot. And then 2 or 3 hours later, she's sitting in a room full of her friends plotting on us.
And the reason why all of her friends went to her house because I posted on her Instagram page when I had the time the stuff she was saying that she was going to end her life. I can't call police from New York, so I posted it on her page for her friends could go save her. So her friends know that she's bugged out and suicidal. So they went to her house.
You know, but that stuff's serious though. Like, that stuff should be put in the proper, you know, like the proper hands. Like suicide is real out here. Like, I know people say stop dry snitching and stuff like that, but a person's life is worth more than just not trying to tell somebody, bro.
Yeah, that's why I put it out there.
You know what I mean?
That's why I put it out there.
Like, come on, man. Like, that's somebody's sister. That's somebody's daughter, man. Come on. Like, man, we value life more than you value life, brother. Like, that's just it right there. But, yeah, so my question for you is, okay, so why do you feel like it all happened so quickly, right? Just, like, how long did y'all break up? Like, how long was it until y'all broke up?
Yesterday, 2 days ago, right? Like, yesterday, the day before yesterday.
You know, if, you know, to me, if a relationship was real and I was really serious about it, it would take me longer to come out and post receipts, you know what I mean? Because I would have to, like, recollect on myself and how I, you know, and how I acted in the relationship. But do y'all not find it funny how it was so quickly after, you know? And I'm just giving the opposite, you know, like the opposite viewpoint, you know what I mean? I'm not trying to, you know, cast any, you know, evidence on nobody. You know, is I'm gonna wait till all the evidence is out to make my decision on if we can, you know, is build kingdoms together and shit like that. But, you know, as we'll see when that comes. But I want to take you at your word. But I have to, you know, have the whole entire perspective.
Bro, there's no evidence of nothing, bro. The only thing is fabricated. She, like you said, like when you're in a relationship, of course you share intimate pictures and stuff like that. Those pictures was there before we even met her. You feel me? Like,
yes.
This is not new pictures. That was pictures when I was locked up, when they took for me. You feel
mm-hmm.
me?
Yeah. Okay. So, when you met Immortal Reyna, or whatever her name was at the time, I mean not Reyna, but Immortal Naomi at the time, right? Did she post heavy carbonation pages, like posts on her channel? Like, did she post? Like,
yeah,
did she have
the? She was posting like nah. She was posting like some people on carbonation, like the some positive quotes and stuff like that. She was.
Like a heavy follower, or just somebody that just tuned in because he was cute?
Heavy follower.
Mm.
And I try to help her. I try to save her. You know, our mission. Like, she got manipulated. She's a manipulator herself, bro. I'm trying to tell you.
Hey, no, you're right, Astrology Quest 4. Wavey, bro, like, you gotta admit this, bro. Why did y'all bring her in so quickly? Like, I know that you're trying to help her, but, like, for me, like, it takes me longer to bring a woman into my, you know, my personal circle to where I'm building, you know what I mean? So why was it so quickly, you know what I mean? Like, did she make it convincing? Like, what was it that made y'all get the process?
Yo, she's smart. She's good with words and convincing, bro. Like, Nature Boy and all them. She's good at that. She's sick, bro, and she got me with the wisdom and all that. What you was going to say?
I said everybody is different. You know how you wait, like, you got to know the person more.
Yes.
He felt that she was giving, you know, good vibes, and we really felt that she was pure, like her intuition was real. We didn't ever think that it was all, like, for, you know, we didn't think that it was fake or none of that. Like, it was just, you know, the vibes was there, and she wanted to build with us. She was, we felt like she was also in the same pace as us. You get what I'm saying? And that's what we failed at. We failed to realize that she really wasn't.
Okay.
But
so,
it's just lessons learned. Like, we ain't taking this is not like a loss. Like, we just learn from this. Like, it's just that's
you see how people are. They know what we trying to do. We gotta
for me, I feel like it's in my teaching, I teach that it's polygamy is built on a strong monogamous bond. So, like, I feel like your intent on why you're building this relationship is important. So for us, you know, ours is family, ours is children, ours is building the best environment for them so we can go out and inspire other children. So my children go out and treat another black woman who may be treated by another shitty ass dude and not get.
And we can't hear you. Is it me?
Yo, you cutting off, bro. hear
yeah,
you?
Yeah, we can hear you.
You back?
So what's your?
Oh.
What's wrong? Hello.
Our relationship intent, like, what was our intentions in the relationship? Cause you're breaking up, we can't really hear you. I wouldn't say fooled, I would say manipulated. That's the right word to use.
Hold on, I'm gonna come back in.
Did I have a gut feeling in the beginning? I did have a gut feeling in the beginning. Like, I had a gut feeling in the beginning. It was suspicious how everything was moving so fast. Like, I guess she was just saying the right things. Like, she knows what to say at the right time, at the right moment, and
she knows what to say, my nigga. Like, she knows how the mind work, like I do. Man, she just be wild.
That sounds like somebody that I know. Huh. That sounds like a fake page right there.
Yeah.
This person.
What up, ladies and gentlemen? Subscribe to my YouTube channel.
Kiss
link
the
in the
bell.
Bio. Kiss the bell. What up? Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Link in the bio. And it's a lot going on. It's just a lot going on, man.
There's a video. Can you send it to me? Because from my knowledge, there's a live that said that he didn't have none of that. Okay. So send me the link so I can see it.
Where?
I don't know. Look, they
video
said
what? A video of what?
They said go do your homework. There's a clips of him admitting to
HIV and herpes. Hey.
Can you leave it like that? That's
like
how he wears days.
No, no, no. You want them to see my dick?
It's a covered. So he pretended to take the test? I'm confused.
Nigga said that fake ass test he took. Facts. Yeah.
Hey.
What up?
Hello?
Yo, what's good?
Hello?
Dekulu, you hear me, Dekulu?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, we back. What's up?
Alright, so, before we get in, alright, I saw the stories, and for me, you know, I stick to my morals and principles. I'm a protector, you know what I mean? So, if I find out, right, that you really are doing what you're doing, you know I have to come for you, right?
If you find out that I'm doing what, bro?
If I find out that what Naomi's saying is true, right? And I'm gonna do my research. We gonna have to come at each other.
Bro, if you wanna do that,
go ahead and do it, because to be honest, she's doing it for attention. She's doing it for clout. She's trying, you don't see what she's trying to do. She's trying to make her own YouTube channel to be monetized.
I'm not stupid. So I'm gonna look at both sides and
you're not dumb.
I wasn't saying you in general, I was saying like people in general. You're not dumb, bro.
Like if you could see, mm-hmm. like my nigga, just put everything together, bro.
The cool, like I really wish that you would have watched some of our videos. Our live videos, like you could really tell that she was jealous. Like she will be pushing me, and people could tell you that she'll be pushing me out the way, or she'll be trying to come up in the thing like this. Like it was just a lot of jealousy. Mhm.
But I'm just letting y'all know that's what I gotta. It's my morals, you know. It's what I stand by. So, you know, I take both sides into account, but I do understand that she did start in carbonation. You know what I mean? So. Alessio's smart like that, you know what I mean, in a certain type of way. So, you know, it wouldn't surprise me if he did try to, you know, plant an agent into your camp to try to destroy your kingdom, you know what I mean? So, hey, you know.
But you, my nigga, but, she can't say nothing, though. Like, you can't say nothing. This is what you come up with. Like, mm-hmm. you can't. Mm-hmm. She, if you let her manipulate you, that means you'll let Nature Boy manipulate you. That's all I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Cause she's smart like that. She got knowledge, and that's how she got me with the knowledge, bro. Yeah. To be honest with you, that's how she got me, bro, with her knowledge. I'm like, yo, that's an addition to our relationship. She's knowledgeable, bro. She knows how to speak and sound. And influential, bro. You got the you get the phone, so
yeah. But I also want to look, you know, also want to switch perspectives and also say that if she is lying, right, then this needs to be an awareness to men out there that there and women that there are men getting lied on. And
yo, bro,
on
can and I tell you something, bro?
Tell you myself, there is women getting lied. I mean, there is men getting lied on and getting lied to and being manipulated. There is.
Like, I know.
Me as a female, I'm not going to lie. I have friends that manipulated guys. I have friends that done all of these things to guys. Girls are petty like that. Some girls don't have a pure heart. People are really malicious out.
And the way she threw her out, like, for no reason, not even a reason, was crazy, bro. Mm-hmm. And she trying to make it seem like she a victim because she want to kill herself. And, like if niggas done something to her, like, her family got a name in Georgia. She's trying to, like, cover up for that shit. Like, she's really, they really sensitive about it. That's Robert Lee, little sister.
Yeah, but... You know, I don't believe in any form of harm, you know, of harming the feminine energy. You know, I do believe that we can, you know, that they can be spoken to in a specific way to where they can be understood.
Yo, let me tell you something. How my ex-girlfriend, right, she called the police and say that I hit her because I cheated on her. Like, she went to the bathroom. You ever saw Thin Line Between Love and Hate? This really happened to me. She went to the bathroom, punched herself in the face, called the police, and then I get arrested. She bails me out. And she do it all over again. And then the judge was like, yo, you're released. Because she's switching up her stories. Like, she's an older female. Females are crazy, bro. And I'm not lying. And the real females, real queens would know I'm not lying. That females are spiteful like that. This happened to me. I'm a victim of that, bro. To be honest with you. The old lady said, oh, I lied. Oh, because she was crazy, bro. She was on cocaine and all that, all types of shit, my nigga. And she lied. And then she said, oh, he didn't hit me. He just broke my TV. Like, come on, my nigga. Like, they do that so they could control your life. Mm-hmm. That was some spiteful shit. To be honest with you. Nobody never knew that, but this is going to show you how malicious and evil people could be.
Yeah, but, you know, if she's posting all this, then she must have something that y'all don't know about. You know?
She only has those pictures that was taken for me when I was locked up for impersonating a police officer when I did that prank. Mm-hmm. She only has those pictures and posting them up online. Like, we could take her pictures and post them up on those same websites. Anybody could post pictures up on websites, bro. And especially have... pictures like that when you're in an intimate relationship with them. Like, come on.
I know, but, you know, we live in a world where women already get treated
but
bad.
But I really got videos of our conversations. That's proof right there. Like, she don't got video conversation talking about, oh, we sex trafficking or anything of that sort. She don't got nothing, like, proving. She don't got no proof. Like, she's a fucking liar.
But you know, okay, but there's always a possibility for anything. You know what I mean? There's
infinite yeah, numbers, yeah. Don't put nothing past nobody.
So my question for you is, let's think in this reality. What if she does have evidence, physical evidence, and she posts it and tells it? Then what?
Yo, bro, she created a fake fucking conversation saying it's Raina's sister. That in Rain, it wasn't even Raina's sister. Like, think about it.
Yo, we good?
Yo, bro, I could say the same shit to you too. If you come out with a, if anybody come out with a video sucking a tranny dick, or if anybody come, if anybody's say, if show proof that yo got videos and proof of your wives selling pussy, then I'm gonna do the same to you.
Facts. And I deserve it. I deserve it by my actions. You know what I mean? I deserve it. You know what I mean? So if it happens, I'm coming, and I want that scalp, man. I want that good hair you got on your head, man.
Yo, you really want it, my nigga? If you want it, you could just run off.
Nah, what she's saying.
You could just help her in Carbonation. If you want to join Carbonation, go ahead.
Nah, fuck Carbonation. But anyways, I defend the feminine energy, the woman. You know what I mean? So my thing is that it has nothing to do with what she's saying now. Is that if hard body evidence comes out and it's confirmed by multiple sources, I'm forced, brother, by my own laws, to come. And when I come quick and I come hard.
I'm the source, bro. I'm the source. I'm the confirmation. I'm the king, bro. King don't take down true kings. When
but if the
when
king
they at war like this, we. You either come together or watch what happens, bro.
Yes,
watch what happens. I respect the fact you ain't gonna choose any side right now because of what you believe in and your morals, and that's why I respect you. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
So it is. I'm in the same thing for you. Like the same thing, the same reasons. Like when it comes to women and protecting them and by these men and manipulators and fucking narcissists and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm all for it. I stand for that. So I respect that shit that you're saying, Kulu. I respect that.
All right. I'm just letting you know the laws and the dimensions in which we're playing in. You know what I mean? And I want the people to know that if there's anybody out there that's manipulating y'all and it's real deal manipulation, right? Don't be afraid to speak up and speak loud. You know what I mean? And hopefully, you know, this inspires real men to stand up. You know what I mean? For women, because like they're already getting treated like shit, and they the only ones that can bring life here.
Oh, we are gonna say the truth. Just follow our channel. Yeah, you're gonna see the truth. We're gonna talk about it. I'm telling y'all, subscribe to our channel. Help us get to 1,000 subscribers, so y'all can know the real story.
Like the real, what really
happened.
What she shared with us, with her personal life as well. That's the truth. Like we can't lie. I'm not. It's a difference between joking and lying. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not making a joke out of this. This is what she really suffering up here. And this, but she made mistakes in her life that she should never have made. And she's trying to, I don't know. She wants attention right now because that's what. People, I don't know. She wants that. She wants attention. Let's see. She's gonna get the attention and get exposed, and everybody's gonna run
and
down.
And if she gets exposed, we have women that will take her scalp as well.
Yeah, we need to go get like what type of woman is that? Niggas trying to do a positive thing and all that. That's like one of your wives leave you and then just trying to make this whole shit the queen.
Exactly. I feel that. And that's the fear. And that's the fear
that's
of a poly relationship. That's the fear that us men go through.
And yeah.
You feel me? And all these dudes that say woke police, what's good?
What's good?
Hey, all these guys in here that say I'm the woke police and things like that, is don't let me, it's put my focus on you, and let's see what we find out about how you treat your woman, right?
Exactly. That's a fact. Yo, bro.
You don't want to get drunk on this internet.
Yo, bro.
In real life, you don't want this smoke, boy.
We play
with this feminine energy right here, man. We don't play
with
this shit, man.
Who that?
I don't know. It's some dudes over here talking, saying I'm the woke police and shit. Hell no, man. This is how we were, brother. Bro, like, this is how we were back in the day, man. We protected our woman like this, bro. It's what happened to these weak-ass niggas like that, man.
Yo, fly away, Mr. Rainey. Get out of here, bro. Niggas, you want to know the truth? Bro. Follow my Instagram. I'll let you know the truth.
Subscribe. Like, that's all you got to do. Like, she's going to really tell you because she was there. Me and Sandy wasn't there. You feel me? Raina was there. Well, how she got treated by Nomine and her family. Mm-hmm. For no reason, bro. Thanks. Her family probably thought she was probably hoeing again and I was a pimp. So her family was like, you're not gonna be labeled as a hoe anymore. Like we mm-hmm. her family, I don't know. But her family didn't believe in polygamy. Cause her family knew we was living right, like, mm-hmm. and you hating cause she was happy. She was happy, bro. Before I came to New York, she was happy. Mm. I didn't get any. All I knew that this, what she's doing to us, this really happened to her, though. And like, seriously, this really happened to her. Her family know about this history before I was even thought about in Atlanta. Her family know her, bro. That this is. Her life or her past, this is her past life. Cause when she was with me, she wasn't doing none of that shit. I wouldn't allow
so
that. My wife.
So what were you offering
doing
her?
That.
So what were you offering her? Like, what did you offer her? It's to make her join your camp. It's to make her join your tribe, your pod.
True love. Real shit, no fake shit. We treated her nothing but love, bro. We never had an argument. She was so. Like being like talking intellectual and convincing, that I fell for it, bro. I'm a victim, bro. I fell for one of them nature boy girls. That's why I was talking to Ra a little bit and fucking around talking to Ra, even though I was joking around.
But you didn't
think
you learned
your lesson? Fuck around, catch some little feelings and be like, oh, nah, this is a godly person. You can't fuck around with queens. Like, I could probably treat her, like, the way Rob was talking, oh, I need a king. I need a tribe. Like, you're better than Nature Boy and stuff. And the way she be talking positivity.
You don't think
stuff.
Nature Boy planted Rob? Like, you don't think Nature Boy was going to plant Rob in your camp?
Now, yeah. Because this is why she mad. That I told everybody because people exposed her. They was like, yo, Ra is just infiltrating.
Mm.
And she was mad. She was like, why did you tell people that we was talking?
Is it true?
I think she really didn't want to fuck with Nature Boy because I'm like, yo, is it true that Nature Boy like transsexuals? She sent me a video, but the video can only play one or two times. And she was like, yes, Wavey P. Nature Boy does like transsexual, yes. Well, she had a little thing on and she was like, yes, Wavey P.
Okay.
Just like that.
All right, fuck the Nature Boy shit. But I'm asking you, is you don't think that it's funny how Raw came your way and then now another immortal girl comes your way? You don't think that's weird?
The immortal girl was already
She was here when Ra hit me up. She was with me.
So you don't think that's weird how two of them will come your way?
And Ileana too.
You don't think that's weird how three of them were trying to come your way? Three people programmed subconsciously by him?
I thought they was looking at me like I'm a better nigga than him and I don't got those demons inside of me. I think they was looking at me like, yo, this nigga really a good nigga. Like, he a real nigga. I thought they was like, fuck Nature Boy. I want to be with Wavey P. And that's what I was supposed to do is wake up these women. So
you don't think that your own ego, because you wanted to show Nature Boy, right? That, man, I had your queen. I have your queen. I'm treating her better, right? That was your mistake in this, right? That you fell victim to.
The intentions, when it comes to polygamy, the intentions got to be right. And if I was trying to be in a polygamous relationship because of that, then that's the wrong intentions, my brother. Mm-hmm. So I didn't take it that far. I broke the promise and exposed our conversation just to show Nature Boy that I could get you a bitch if I wanted to. But that's not the right reason. Even though she's small or anything, but then again, she has sex with
you. You don't think this is karma for that?
It's an L.
It's an L?
It's a loss. It's a king.
What's the loss?
A king got fooled one time, but a king can't get fooled again.
What's the lesson?
Get to know the person past. Do your research.
Meet the family first before
let meet the family first.
Cause what y'all don't understand is that she acted a different way with us in New York, and once we got to Atlanta, she acted another way. You see it? In New York, she acted a different way. In Atlanta, she showed us her true colors.
Don't meet nobody off of Nature Boy's live.
That's another lesson.
Don't meet nobody off of Nature Boy live. Get to know the person before bringing them into your life and sharing your world. And because when you do that, like with us, when we bring you, we like it's all love. If you're on the same frequency, like we feel like you got pure intentions. It's all love. We was helping her, like, yo, go find a job while I'm out here.
All right,
while I'm out here working.
A decision haven't been made yet, but I got my evidence that I needed. I'm going to do more research. And when she posts her post, when she gets her subscribers, we'll see. And you'll know when the siren's ringing. And when the post comes, I'm coming for that scout. If you did,
the most you're gonna see, bro. All I'm telling you is, the most you could see is my wife's intimate pictures, and that's on a website that we never even heard about.
Yes,
website.
But I'm talking about real life.
I never heard about.
I'm talking about, like, you know, like the pictures is like we all have pictures of our own, you know, our own intimate partners. You know what I mean? So we can't play.
But I'm saying she posted them on websites that's for like escort and websites. You feel me? That's she did that like she capable because she knows how to do that. You feel me?
Yes.
She
yes.
was in that life. She knows how to post pictures and what websites to post them. Those ads for free and all that. She knows that. She tried to. So she putting stuff up and numbers and all that. But if you want to come for my scalp, if you want to join that side, be more than welcome, my nigga.
I'm not joining that side, brother. I'm just telling you my morals and principles. You know what I mean? And
this is why I fuck with you, because we got the same morals and principles. But you keep trying to challenge me.
and you know when you first came into my life, what was the first thing you said?
I'm the light skinned alpha male.
Okay, don't think I forgot that.
I didn't give you your props, bro. Like I didn't.
Nah, you did. But don't think I forgot.
They don't gotta go through me before they get to you. Like
they do. They
my
do.
Nigga, I don't give you the respect. I don't honor your knowledge, my nigga. Like, what type of shit is this?
You do.
This is but what you do? This is some.
You respect it.
This is some Nature Boy it. Shit. What he does to his followers, bro. That's crazy. You're not being.
I'm trying to be serious. I'm trying to be serious because we developed that funny humorous like relationship. You know what I mean? But you should respect the fact that I'm staying to my morals. And if you know
it, I do respect it because I stand for the same morals. How can I not respect? That means I don't respect.
But if there's like real hard physical evidence of you actually doing what she says, like all the bullshit, then that's your actions being recorded. And I'm coming. I'm coming hard. I'm coming fast.
I believe you. I believe you.
And I'm a Man, I got special I got special case for your scalp too.
Oh man.
But I'm out.
My nigga, the Kulu's a fucking king for real. That nigga is a king. Like you can't get mad at him. He's a warrior, man. And that's how warrior moves.
I know I'm pretty. That's why every time somebody says otherwise, I really don't care. And none of that phases me, bro. Like, to be honest, if I sit here and tell y'all what I went through as a little girl, y'all will understand why none of this phases me. Because all of this is regular fucking shit now. Like, what the fuck? Like, niggas call.
I say if you don't say nothing, homie, I observe. I'm a very intellectual observer. Let me tell you that much. I don't have to say nothing. All right? I keep my thoughts to myself.
Baby, fuck up my love. What he doing?
Nah. Why you say that?
I can't see you.
I know. I know, but they could see me. I don't know why it's like that.
Oh, okay.
Y'all could see me, right?
Nah, you frozen right now.
Nah, I'm saying the people in the comments, y'all can see me?
Hey, what's up? Ferg. I don't know how to pronounce your name. I forgot one. I'm sorry. What's up, Ferg? How are you?
My baby girls, I love y'all.
Yeah, the thing about Sandy is that she's an observer. She likes to observe before she speaks anything.
That's why she never got too close around her. Because with her, it takes time. You got to be in her life for years for her to really caress you and be intimate with you like that.
And me, I'm a very understanding person. So I tend to understand everybody and give them the benefit of a doubt until they prove otherwise. Boy, if I was to sit here and tell you what's going on, man. Stay tuned to my YouTube channel, though, yo.
I'm put her real name, her picture, shit crazy. Her charges, she's fighting
This is all gonna
be wonderful at the end. This is all gonna play out beautiful. Cause what we gonna show y'all, she's scared, so she's trying to, but it's not gonna work. Cause this is
why don't y'all go come at her? She got her 100 subscribers. Tell her to put out the video.
Sexy eyes, baby girl. This is my real hair. I don't look crazy, ma. Check my profile.
Don't listen to the comments, ma. Come back to the room, because I think that's why it's fucking up.
Nah, it's not fucking up. I'll see you perfectly
fine. In my phone.
Nothing even matters at all. Your love makes me feel 10 feet tall. With all that I go through withdrawal, cause nothing even matters at all. Nothing even matters. Nothing even matters at all. Nothing even matters. Nothing
these
matters
buildings could drift out to sea. Some natural catastrophe. Still there's no place I'd rather be. Cause nothing even matters to me. See, nothing even matters. See, nothing even matters to me. Nothing even matters. Nothing even matters.
You're part of my identity. I sometimes have a tendency to look at you religiously, babe. Cause nothing even matters to me. Nothing even matters. Nothing even matters to me. Sit it on my baby, baby.
Now you won't find me at no store. I have no time for manicures. With you it's never either. Cause nothing even matters no more. See nothing, it don't matter. See nothing even matters no more. Nothing even matters. Nothing even matters.
Now my team must go and make it to the final fall. Just repossess my fault, my fault, fault. Cause nothing even matters no more. Nothing even matters. Nothing even matters no more. Nothing even matters. Oh, oh, oh.
Funny on this day when I pulled up on him, I pulled up yelling Yerp, and he started ducking. He started, oh my god, he was like, he got scared because that was right after the live where Chief kind of like shut him down, and he became sour about that, and that's why he started disowning Chief and acting like he wasn't a part of what we started. The only reason I knew this nigga was from Chief's lives, so he had to have been following Chief before I ever even met him. And then I met him through Chief's lives, and then I met him through Chief's knowledge. So I don't understand how he can have the audacity to say that I was following him. Actually, I was correcting him. This nigga was sitting here talking about numbers. I'm trying to get him to be practical. For real, the whole act he's doing right now is not him. He's not a tough guy.
What's good?
Yo, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Guys, we good in the chat? Because I want this to be a constructive build.
Before you guys start building, can
I want to start off by saying, brother, you know I really fuck with you, brother, at first, right? Like, you know, I really was fucking with you. You know that, right?
You said if you had any more new information, you was going to come for my scope. I want to know what's the new information, brother. So-called.
Okay. All right. Right? But
what's the new information you got?
I'm going to get there.
What's the new information you got? You just wanted to do this, bro. My nigga,
The new information?
I wanted to do this.
Yeah. Wavy, can we have a constructive build, please? I'm trying to direct it so we can both get our points out.
All right, direct it. I'm listening, bro.
Every person is my brother, whether you like it or not. Right? But, hey, man, can you show your face?
But let me tell you something. I'm your father. Father, my nigga. I created you, my nigga. You didn't say, yo, please, can you get me a debate with Chief? My brother, I want to debate Chief. If you could get me on the T. You ain't say that? Matter of fact, you ain't say the T, yeah, but you want me to play it?
Play it, please.
What did you say?
Play it.
What did you say?
Can you please play it for the people?
What did you say? About the skits, brother. You try to say it was a skit now? The voice notes was
play
a
it.
Skit? Now, on your last
I didn't say the voice note was a skit.
You said the voice note.
No, you let me speak.
How a voice note is a skit?
No, I didn't say that was a skit. I said the voice. Is you gonna let me speak? Hello?
How the
voice I didn't say the voice note was a skit. I didn't say the voice notes were a skit. I said that we were talking about creating a skit. Yes or no?
You said we could create skits. You said I'm a funny guy and all that. You want to create skits?
Yes, I said that already on live camera.
All right,
I said that to the people.
What about the clout chasing stuff? What about you creating drama online and stuff? The voice notes. Those are skits too, right? The drama online, right?
No, they're not skits. The voice notes was letting you know.
So you telling me you didn't say that? Let me see this phone. I've been waiting for this moment, bro.
I'm telling you that in the voice notes.
I've been waiting for this moment.
Wavey, can you let me explain? Okay, because I want you to play it. I want you to play it for the people, right? But you took it the wrong way, right? In the voice notes, me and Wavey connected over comedy, Wavey? We connected over comedy, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. In those voice notes that you're about to play, that the people are about to hear, I talk about creating skits with you in those voice notes, right?
Yes, on two of them, you talked about creating skits.
Okay. Those skits that I was talking about.
There's a few of them that got nothing to do with, that's not related to skits. That's related to
clout chasing. I want you to play them.
It's related to clout chasing.
Okay, and I want you to play it. Okay? But those two voice notes that you're talking about, right? Those weren't skits. I was building with you about future skits that we were going to create when I was going to New York.
So what about when you was in Carbonation and you sent me the tranny porn?
When was I in Carbonation?
When you met up with Sola and you sent me the tranny porn so me and you could attack Chief together. You wanted to clout chase with me.
I sent you the tranny porn now. I sent you the tranny porn now.
That's a fact. And you want me...
Really? Really?
Yeah.
Really? Wavey, I sent you to tranny porn.
You did not... You wasn't in California with Sola?
That was 2 years ago, brother.
Why? That was 2 years ago? So that was around...
Yes, brother, in July of 2018.
That was around the time Chief did the tranny porn, right? Am I right or wrong?
No. That tranny porn was back when Chief was a gay stripper.
So when did Chief did the tranny porn?
I don't know. I assume back when he was a gay stripper, back in Atlanta.
Oh, so, all right. It was back when he was a gay stripper?
That's what I assume.
Who sent you the tranny porn?
You sent me the tranny porn.
I sent you the tranny porn. But you was a part of the yo, my nigga. You met up with Sola, right?
Yes.
How you know Sola?
So Solar met up with me.
Solar, man, how much time you spent with him?
We spent 4 hours.
Y'all spent 4 hours. Didn't you say I love myself and all that, right?
I didn't say that. No, I didn't.
You didn't do this?
No, I didn't do that. Show me a video.
Show you a video?
Yeah.
Yo, my nigga, you didn't leave Carbonation Catrice try to take your girl? And you left?
Nope. Show me a video.
You didn't leave Carbonation because Chief took your wife. He tried your...
what wife did Chief take?
Yo, bro, you a clout chaser, man. You over here talking. You a smart dude, my nigga. You're smart. You got that intellect. You got it. But my nigga, I'm going to pull your demons out of you, nigga. I pull demons out of people, nigga. Let's talk the truth about you and Solar, nigga.
Wavy. Stop trying to create beef. I've already proved Solar. And I got a brother right now. I got a brother right now, Wavy. Name. You know what? You want to bring up Solar? Let's get him. You want to bring up Solar?
That's your man.
Right now that can validate.
You're talking about your own people. Your was in Carbonation. When this nigga had the hair and he was behind with the trees and shit, he was following Chief. You want to be like Chief.
Really?
You want to be like Chief. And you had to join up with me to take him down. Because we can't take him down by ourselves.
Wavy, I debated Chief before you.
I was just clever enough and creative enough. And that's why we joined forces to take down the astrological program. That's not good for the community. And that's why we joined forces. So your reason
for
trying to attack me
that we discussed
is because you want clout, nigga. You want clout. And that's why.
I want clout.
You do.
I want clout.
That's why you want. That's why you used a Carbonation before. You lying right now to the people.
Really?
You are a fucking liar. This nigga wasn't Carbonation.
So I was a Carbonation,
before.
Right?
You a Carbonation.
I was a Carbonation,
nigga.
Right?
Chief is your Messiah, nigga. Just know Chief is your Messiah.
You want to prove it? Snapchat memories don't lie, Wavy. Snapchat memories don't lie. Like, let me show you 2 years ago. If I was really about Carbonation, like you say, Snapchat memories don't lie. So let's go through 2 years ago. Back when I was in a van in California, since you want to talk about that mess, right? And there's a brother in here named PR19SE, Price, right? And I'm going to show you how we commented it 2 years ago and how me and Price were back on our own tribe doing our own van life group and how Solar wanted to join that, okay?
Nah,
so don't try to come up here, brother.
True.
I got the evidence,
you
brother.
To join
I got
Chief.
The evidence.
You wanted to be
brother,
like
I got the evidence, brother.
You wanted to
I
want to
be like Chief,
Chief,
right? But weren't you with Chief, though? Like, weren't you in Carbonation, brother?
No. You
so,
was.
So you didn't. So there's no
people
video
to
you and
People
try
to paint the picture on me about themselves, nigga. That's really y'all niggas, man. That's not me. That's y'all niggas, man.
Really?
Fuck is wrong with you, nigga?
Were you the one in his live, though?
Yeah, I was in his live. Nigga. That's
so
just
how
live,
is,
nigga.
How are we, how are we projecting that
live.
Onto you if you were in his
too.
Physical life?
And you a liar.
Just
I'm
now.
You're alive and you
just
a liar.
Now,
you
bro.
A fake nigga, bro.
You've only been alive the
you're
last
bitch.
3 weeks, bro. You've only been on my
nigga,
page the last 3 weeks.
Fake nigga. Yo, bro, we done did comedy.
Oh, really? Really?
My nigga, look back on
hey,
the lives.
Hey, right.
Me and you, we created those lives, man, nigga. We spoke about the lives before we went live, nigga. We articulated the lives. And how we was gonna bring
right.
more viewers, nigga.
Daisy,
we did that.
Hey Daisy, right here. If I really joined Carbonation, bro. If I was really about Carbonation, right here. As I'm gonna show y'all, I'm gonna prove it to y'all. Here's the photo. That's all I wanna play, right? Right here. Here's the photo. Right. Now let's go look at the comments because notice he's not giving no honor or thanks to Chief.
Let me see the picture. Let me see the
So
picture.
How is he part of Carbonation? Look. Right? How is he not giving no honor to Chief?
My nigga. My
if he was with Chief at the time, like he claimed,
nigga,
bro.
This is my opinion.
Hold on.
My
nah,
opinion?
Bro. Now it's not no opinion, bro. Like, now it wants to turn into opinion. You can't come up here and make false allegations, and now it's opinion and shit.
My nigga, you got
my brother, Price.
Him. You got a picture
okay, because he was joining my van life tribe, bro.
You in Carbonation.
Bro, he was joining my tribe,
nobody
bro.
Wanna live in a, nobody
he was joining
wanna
my
live
tribe.
In a minivan, though. Nobody want to live in a minivan. Nobody want to live in a minivan. I don't know what real woman want to live
right?
in a minivan with you, bro. Whoever want to live in a minivan
shit,
with
my,
you
shit,
is,
my,
is
shit,
a monkey. Only monkeys want to live
really?
In a minivan, nigga.
Okay.
Oh, so now you calling my woman a monkey now? It's because she's dark skinned now. Not like now you're showing your true colors. Not like now you're a racist. No, now you call my black woman a monkey now? So now you call all black women monkeys now?
No,
bro.
That's not what I said.
Weak ass shit, bro. Get the fuck out of here, man. That's what you said, bro. You said a monkey, bro. Get the fuck out of here with that weak ass racist shit, bro. Look at this shit, bro. If y'all really want to ask somebody, bro, go ask Daisy. Go ask our Soul Spaces. Go ask Price. He's in here right now. Go ask these individuals if I was really joining Carbonation. Because these are Price, as you see pinned down right here, commented 81 weeks ago. Back when this photo was taking place. So y'all go ask Price if I was really in Carbonation. Bro, y'all go ask Daisy if I'm really in Carbonation. Or if I ever have been. See, I brought you on live to expose your bitch ass. Hold on, let's bring my brother World in, because this is some crazy shit, bro. It's some crazy shit. You hear that shit, bro? You just trying to call my girl a monkey. That.
Doing illegal shit, I feel like just shut it down. Don't get people involved. This word to anybody out there. Fuck talking to anybody. You dig? Fuck, these people don't know shit. These people don't know about polygyny. These people act like they your friends, but they not. You dig? These people ain't got no heart for us. They don't feel you. When they see a dude doing polygyny, they hating on you. They feel like fuck you. They feel like you think you whatever, you know? And they hating. The same way how some people see a badass bitch and they just hate her. They said that's velvet. Somebody jury and then jury. Oh, no. Check my facts. I did it first, baby. Check the history. I don't even know who y'all naming. Who's Nana? But before they even got on this, go check back a decade ago. Yakian was here first.
Yakian, that's my God.
You did? Hey. I've been doing polygyny over 10 years. I got women with me right now. We've been together over 10 years.
Yakian's my God.
She done seen so many women come and go.
That's what's up. And what? Yeah, that make y'all stronger, right? That make y'all more strong. I never seen, y'all ever had a girl like this? My ex that left?
Yeah.
Hey, I wasn't even with her for a month.
Yeah, no, that's a good.
Y'all ever had a girl like that?
I'm going to talk about her in the next live. Let's start a new one so we can say this. That's real, though.
All right, let's save it. Act like he in a polygamous relationship. And he only with one wife, bro. You think because you talk to a girl online, they your wife, my nigga? Like, you never even met her before. You're not in a polygamous relationship. You with that one person.
That happens. Yeah, that happens.
That look like she played. That look like Serena Williams' cousin or somebody. Serena Williams is bad, but she looked like Broderick a little bit. Like she would knock a nigga out. That's what I'm saying.
Right, I haven't seen. Like she knock a nigga out.
But what disrespects her? You feel me? I don't want no problems.
There are a lot of people who talk about, they have a lot to say about polygyny, and they talk bad about people that's doing it, and they never did.
And they're not doing it. They're not doing it themselves.
It's a lot of
girls.
They're
not even doing it themselves.
They talking to a dude online, and they call that polygyny. Y'all cyber dating.
Yeah.
That's not polygyny.
Yo, my nigga, they was talking about me for 5 hours last night. This nigga went on live 5 times the whole hour talking about Wavey P. I told his so-called wife, yo, well, yeah, man. It's just talking about me. You might as well be with me. Like, he want to make receipts. This is how he's a clout chaser. He want to create receipts that me and his wife is talking so he can make a publicity stunt so all the attention could go to him so he could teach his knowledge. That was the plan. So you'd rather degrade your wife loyalty just for you could get clout.
Right.
That's, you'd rather embarrass your wife, make her look like she a hoe.
Right, but like you said, bro.
Why is she talking to you?
She's not there yet. That's not a real wife. Right?
She's not even there yet. But he sacrificed her to make her look like a hoe so he could get clout.
Hey,
this nigga's a dishonorable ass nigga. The nigga was in Carbonation before, and he denying it too.
Oh, he was in Carbonation?
He was in Carbonation trying to act like he was his own man. try to act like he never met Solar when Solar put the picture of him and the other girl that was in combination. He thought that shit was gonna get swept under the rug. My nigga, you a lost soul. You was following under the next man at one point in your life 2 years ago. Don't try to come out of nowhere and try to act. You thought that shit died down and people forgot about you, nigga. Nobody forgot about that.
Yeah, because at the end of the day, man, you know, ain't nobody that's really doing polygyny gonna want to tear anybody else down. When I seen you for the first time, you know, we may not be doing exactly the same thing or anything, right? But I never go, that ain't my brother. My queens know, when right. I seen you, just like I said, when I seen you, I said, oh, this my brother on the path. We could be different.
That's a fact.
But just like nature, when I see nature, that's my brother on the path. We could be different. But why would I want to tear down my brother?
Right.
You dig what I'm saying?
That's a fact.
So, you know, I feel like...
He's doing it because people like drama, people like that soap opera stuff, like that negativity. Nobody want to listen to this nigga live talking about the numbers and the circles and none of that shit. Nobody listen to that shit. That shit is really, really boring, bro. He had to come up. He was like, yo, you do comedy skits. This is a good thing. Like, you do the comedy. Let's pick up receipts to my wife. That you was talking to my wife so people could get attention so that I could teach the knowledge. Come on, my nigga. He's a clout chaser. He knows what he's doing, my nigga, because I'm a clout chaser myself, nigga. He know that. So he tried to clout chase with me. Fuck out of here, man.
Right. He's not genuine about it, huh?
He's not admitting to me. I'm a clout chaser, nigga. I make up shit so people can get, I can get people attention. I'll be better. That I make something interesting up just like he wanted to do with me. You feel me? He don't want to admit that he a clout chaser. He don't want to admit that he was in combination.
It could be entertainment. Like, there's nothing wrong with that. Everybody got their own. Everybody got things they can bring to the community, you know. And it's nothing wrong with that.
It could be entertainment. That was not entertaining. First, you was like, oh.
Well, like, I could barely hear you. You going out. Come back by your Wi-Fi, bro. But yeah, what happens a lot of times in polygyny is dudes will just get with a girl, and then what they'll do is just like get with one girl, and then they're like, oh, I'm doing polygyny, and women buy the idea of the polygyny he could do. Mm-hmm. You know.
That's still not doing polygyny.
I just come right back in, bro. Why though? I don't know. I'm just scrolling through the comments saying, ooh, I see some love. I see some love in here. I appreciate it.
Yekin is my God.
Yekin is my God.
Yeah, it's a lot of love in here. Wavey, where you at? Get back on the Wi-Fi. We wrapping it up, though. But it's cool. He just wanted to know about some of the relationships I've been through. I've been through all type of shit, you know. We've had queens who just, you know, just like I said, just want to have a good time and really down to build.
Right.
You know, and then when it's time to build, they not in touch with themselves enough. So when you want to talk about stuff, they think every conversation is an argument.
Right.
And ain't nobody even arguing.
Yeah.
So, you know, you can deal with so many different type of characters that may not be on your level. They ain't did the healing. They haven't did the soul searching. So it's like, shit, we raw around here, you know.
Yeah, for real. Yekin is the truth.
Yekin is my God.
Yekin is my God.
Appreciate y'all, queens.
My bad. She's watching the live right now. She's calling my phone, fucking up, interrupting the live right now. You see how crazy she is, bro. Like, but listen. You see how your ex-wife, she got molested when she was a child, and she tried to say you molested one of your wives because she was 18?
Right. But I wouldn't call her my ex-wife. She was just the girl I was courting, you know.
All right. That girl, so this girl that was in my life, she's trying to bring the escort that my wives are escorting. But the funny thing is, when we was together, she was telling me how she got exposed to her family members. Somebody reached out to her family members and exposed of her hustle. I'm not knocking her hustle. I didn't judge her for her past hustle. I look past that. Yeah. I look at you as a personality and how you are spiritually.
Right.
You
and feel me?
So people like, why did you take her in if you knew she was a hoe or she was hoeing back in the day? I didn't know. This is after.
Yeah, and then it never mattered, though. It never mattered, though. You did what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's bigger than
but
that.
She got exposed like, for that. Corny.
You did what I'm saying? It's bigger
she
than that.
She got exposed for that, and now she's trying to make us feel that pain that she felt. Her right. family members trying to hit Raina family members and trying to say that she's doing the same thing. Like, why is her mom doing what was done? Like, her mom was brought the information that her daughter was selling pussy. Now her mom want to tell her family so her family could feel the same hurt that her mom felt. She like, I'm a mother, so I'm going to make sure her mother feels the
exactly,
same way.
Bro. That's what they do, bro. That's why they are. That's what I'm saying, but that's that low vibrational shit. That's what I'm saying, bro. You got people coming at me just because the mom mad. Look, even the girl mom who was 18, her mom was mad that she with me. You get it? I spoke to the mom on the phone, right? Record the whole conversation. We got a good conversation. She know it's legal. The girl 18 and the girl want to move out, too. She grown. She can legally leave. You did?
The mama, right.
Me and the mama spoke, right? Then a few weeks later, the mama tripped. Now, her, the girl you dealing with, her mom, they got their own issues. The girl, one of the girls I was dealing with, her mother got, you know, this child support dynamic and this EBT dynamic. You know, she getting benefits and she need the girl to stay there. You know what I mean? So,
right.
But the girl leave. You did? I'm fucking her hustle up. I don't even know. I ain't even thinking about it. You dig what I'm saying? And I speak to her, whatever, it's cool. Long story short, they try that same shit talking about you did something that wasn't right or, you know, and you doing some sex trafficking or you doing something. But here go the thing, bro. If what we doing is illegal, why they ain't fucking with you? But here go the problem, Wavy. I don't want nobody watching you. And that's why it's bigger than you. Anybody watching this, right? Don't entertain them clowns. It's okay, shit on them. But when they accusing you of some shit, right? Don't entertain it because the system do want brothers. Even though you ain't did nothing. You did? Even though you ain't did nothing. They still, the system wants you. And these people is sick. And they trying to play in that because R. Kelly is out and all this stuff. But guess what? The girl mom got with the girl that left here. The girl who left here found the girl mom. Because we told her about it. You did? And she found the girl mom. And that's why she played that game. And then they start telling people, and people are like, you gotta believe it. It's a mama. You did? But that don't mean shit. Then they believe it because somebody believe it or nothing. I think they believe it. But all that pain is real, but it don't come from me. That pain
exactly.
was already there. You did?
The pain was already there.
Now,
it was already there.
It was already there. And then instead, they want to shoot it all at you.
Right.
And that's the kind of shit that come with polygyny. That a goofy motherfucker don't respect about us. They think this shit all beautiful. But the men go through a lot and a lot get put on us. We get all the demonized. We get demonized a lot. For a lot of shit we ain't got nothing to do with. You know? But what it's gonna do is, bro, it make you and your queens that's there stronger because everybody seen it.
You did? Right.
Everybody
they don't
like,
break them.
I seen that. You did?
Right.
And that make y'all stronger. So me and my queen solid too because it's like they know everything a lot. People talking about we didn't. Did this, we done did that, and this happened and that happened, but it never happened.
Right.
Crazy as fuck.
You get it?
Yo, son.
So, yeah.
How like my wives is skeptical right now. We they don't even wanna when the day that shit happened, she was like, yo, please don't bring no other girl. I just want me and Sandy. Like, how do y'all overcome that when it comes to like
okay, that's real.
Trust in bringing new women now, like.
That's real. What we do is we try to keep an open heart, you know what I'm saying? And just still build with women, like, just naturally, you know what I mean? And just be real with them. But what we do is we just, we kind of take our time with how we be in front of them. Because you can't be all of you in front of them. And they're going to want you to, you know. They're going to want you to make love to your girl right in front of them, you know. They gonna want you to love your girl up. They gonna want you to talk about your deepest, darkest secrets with your girl right in front of them. But don't do it. You know what I'm saying? That's what you do. You take your time just like they taking their time. And you let them all the way in when they ready. That's what we learn to do is like, you know. And then we learn they start getting mad about that. We had girls leave because of that. Because they go, sometimes they go, well, look,
It's not as much loving going around here as I thought. And we go, we ain't loving as hard because you here. And you stale. Because your ass stale, your stale ass fucking up the vibe.
Yo, I feel you 100%, and a lot of people won't understand that. Because they don't feel what we feel when the other presence is around.
There you go. Because you already got your vibe. You're feeling good. You dig? And then you go, this goofy motherfucker, right? All weird. And then now you and your girl got to adjust.
Right.
And they don't understand this shit because they never did this shit. And they just act like,
oh, I didn't see this. No, I didn't see that.
Well, motherfucker, part of the bad problem around here, your ass. Because once your ass leave, we dancing in this motherfucker. You dig what I'm saying?
So that's a fact. Everything back to normal.
Yeah, so they be goofballs. So, you know, just let your girls know that, you know, stay bigger than these people, bro. Don't let them fuck up the vibe. You dig? Stay bigger than them. But, you know, tighten up when they there, like, fuck it. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes when they there and you want to love all of them, you might want to fuck your girl right there in front of her. Fuck it. I can't even love her like that right in front of you yet. You dig?
She ain't in enough to be that vulnerable.
There you go. She not in with y'all enough to even have that vulnerable moment. You dig what I'm saying? With y'all. She ain't open enough yet. Like you said, you still finding out their secrets. You know what I'm saying?
Shit is crazy.
Yeah.
Like, you gotta tell. I've asked her, like, is there anything you need to know? Anything I need to know before we go in Atlanta? Anything. We go to Atlanta, her motherfucking lights turn off the same day. Not even 2 hours we've been there, the lights. Oh, I was supposed to pay the light. I rescheduled the light and I extended the light payment. And I was supposed to pay it. Now I gotta pay the whole thing. Yeah. We done pay the whole thing. She ain't tell us that.
Yeah.
She ain't tell us about her 3 months backed up rent.
Yeah.
This is something you tell people before you drag people with your problems in a relationship, my nigga. Like, I got a house in New York, and then we go to Atlanta, all to know that she got nothing but bills and backed up shit.
Right.
That now I'm like, ain't nothing. We in this together now. But damn, we try to help you. We didn't need you.
Right.
We was perfectly fine, bro.
Right.
We didn't have no backed up rent, no phone bills. Her phone was off. Everything turned off. She losing everything right now.
Right.
And that's why she wanted to kill herself. Because she lost me and she did us dirty for no reason. Not a reason, bro. Mm. When I tell you we treated her with nothing but love, we ain't do nothing to her. This is why she's suicidal, my nigga. I'm like, this is why. Like, you hurt people for no reason. She threw Raina's stuff out in the street in Atlanta, bro.
She threw her clothes out?
And my clothes out, too, while we in New York. Trying to get money to help her goofy ass out.
Yeah, well, that's what happens sometimes. Like, you put the power in her hand because y'all went to her turf. You see what I'm saying? But next time, what you got to do is, look, next time when the girl got the bright idea how she can build with y'all, how y'all can go to her spot, you got to go, yo, I like that idea, but let's slow down. I can't build with you on that because you might be weird. And then the girl going to tell you, no, I ain't weird. I never do some fake shit. You did? And they probably still gonna do it anyway.
Right.
But my whole thing is I like to address it. Cause everything that I do, I talk about it first. Like, you know, and then I even wait on it. And then when the girl do it, man, girl, you know you crazy. You dig? Cause you know damn well you shouldn't have did that. You dig? So yeah,
that's a fact. That's a fact, bro.
Man.
She's as wild. I'm not telling you out of nowhere for no reason. We never had an argument, bro. Never had a disagreement. Only thing was, she was drinking and I told her not to drink. And this is a crazy thing. I told her not to drink for a reason because she acts dumb. She started drinking that night, and that's when everything happened.
One of my friends laughing because she's saying that sounds like some shit we done been through. You see what I'm saying? Because that's real. That happens.
It's real shit, bro.
That happens, yeah. But somebody who's not polygynous, they don't understand that.
Right.
You dig what I'm saying? They don't understand that. You know what I'm saying? And then they think it got to be the dude's fault. Just because you polygynous, you got to be the big pimp master. You know what I'm saying? You know, and it's just like, nah, man, you know, these queens powerful.
Yeah, Ken is my
Any woman that's going to do polygyny is powerful.
Exactly. You embrace them, you praise them. Like, you don't take advantage of that. If a woman is really the want to build with you and all that, you don't take advantage of that.
Right. Facts. Yeah, man, you know, like I said, man, that remind me of so much. But like I said, it really come down to people can't keep up. It take energy. It's just like, you know, people want to join gangs. Little dudes want to join gangs. And then when they get down with the gang, they can't take it. They can't hang. They be
doing right.
Shit, and the gang be like, yo, that was lame. What the fuck was that? And they start feeling too small. But you know it. They running and hiding and they snitching. And that's gay. Is that not lame?
Yeah. Niggas is dry snitching, niggas is lying, niggas is widows, is faggots, cause our life better than them. There you go. Be honest with you.
There you go. Facts. My God. And that's why we don't even be caring, like, you know, and that's why I like how you was doing it, cause it's like, who gives a fuck, man? They gonna troll. But like I said, bigger than me and you, is anybody watching, if you do polygyny, do not play when it comes to these weirdos and their allegations, though. Laugh at them about everything else. But when it come about, you know what I'm saying, if they saying you pimping or something that could bring laws around you with guns, right? Don't play with them. You can shit on them, but don't play with them. You did? Because I'm telling you, fuck them. The system wants you. And that's what these fools, they like, they don't know this. And it's like, but they can't. They claim to be pro-black. But you don't know the systematic racism. But you don't know the you don't know how this beast work. And you play like that, but you claim to be black. Hey, the girl mama called the police on us. You did? We beat them to the punch, nigga. We went to the police station.
Right.
Cause we ain't getting nothing illegal. But I'd rather show up and talk this out before you motherfuckers come looking for us.
Right.
With guns out on some weirdo shit. You dig what I'm saying? That shit wrong, man. That shit ain't cool. You know what I'm saying? That shit ain't, and they kinda be pro-black.
Right.
And they be the same motherfuckers posting shit on their page talking about it's wrong when the white lady called the police on the black niggas doing nothing at the park. Or it's wrong when this happened. And that's all these motherfuckers do.
Right.
Like, what proof do they really have? Bruh, like I said, I just tapped into what you're doing, right? How the fuck could I say you pimping? How the fuck can anybody say you pimping?
Right.
Don't you get it? But they want to say you pimping, and to me, that's dangerous. And that's weird. Because that's bad for people, man. That's bad. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, but people claim they love each other, you know? You know? They claim they love us. They claim they love the conscious people. They claim they love brothers who's down to do polygyny. They claim they love sisters. That's down to do polygyny, but guess what? They talking all shit about your queens too, ain't they? Exactly.
Yeah, cause of my ex-wife, she took our intimate photos, start putting up on these websites. I could take, you mm-hmm. could send me a naked picture of a girl I never met before, and I could post them up on those websites as well.
Right.
Like, that's not, that
but
don't.
That's wrong though, putting pictures up there, but look, here go the thing. Yeah, that's wrong shit. I'm still thinking about that. But yeah, but here go the thing, man. These motherfuckers, right, they'll do anything to try to tear you down because they really demonize you. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I learned. Like I said, the same girl was talking about, like I said, calling the police on me. You know what I mean? But it's like, how you calling the police on something that never happened?
Exactly. She's telling the T that she's going to get lawyers and stuff like that. She don't even got money for her phone bill. Like, it's just crazy. I don't know what's... She wanna see me under the bus, but I just treat her nothing but love. Why you wanna see me down? Like, where all that hate come from?
Mm-hmm.
I just don't understand. I never... This is the type of people... Like, a lot of people need to watch out for. Like, that shit was... Like, I was blindsided, bro. I never saw it coming. You feel me? I never saw it coming. I didn't feel the energy. Like, it was just, she was acting like she was vibrating with us and talking all this positivity every day.
Yeah, see, but you probably seen the energy a little bit, though. Huh? I mean, because this be my situation, bro. I see the energy, but I figure you changing because you here.
Mm.
I see it.
But yeah, she acted perfect. It was perfect. It was nothing, no correction. She was like, let's do yoga and stuff like that. Like, you know, she was...
I have to say, when they first come, they have the charge, but it's almost kind of like a fake charge or whatever. But then, like, when they actually trying to put that all into what they just came into, that charge is, like, leaving.
The same thing happened in relationships, even with a one-on-one, when they doing monogamy. Like, all them people who be hating on people doing polygyny, they probably be single anyway. And guess what? They be dating. And if we go line up all they exes, right? All the people they've been dating, the one you dated for 3 weeks, the one you dated for 2 months, they be talking all shit about them too.
Right.
And also, don't even know them like that neither anyway.
Right. Why you think Kiss the Veil is single? Because the bitch is really crazy, bro.
I don't know who that is.
kiss. She, yo, she's really, she's a bug out. She be one of those that be talking about everything. She was saying how my wives was down the river shaking that ass and all that. She just be playing around too much. But she been single for a very long time. And she never had a man because she's a bug out. She looked like a bipolar bug out, bro.
Mm.
Forget about her.
No, but it's deep because yeah, beyond her, it do tell you something. If the woman ain't got a man, that tell you something.
Right, yeah, these same people.
If the man ain't got women, that tell you something, man. Because when a brother got women, it tell me something. When I seen you and you had queens, it told me something. I don't give a fuck how much he dance and playing. He know what he doing. You dig? Motherfucker doing something. Because everybody can't do this.
Right.
You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Motherfuckers can't do this.
Yeah.
Well, I look at your queens. I say, oh, shit, I got respect for them. When I meet somebody and they doing polygyny, immediately you done got my respect on a certain level. Like, oh, you my brother. Oh, your queens, they queens. I respect them.
Right.
I know what type of strength that take. I know what type of real, raw-ass relationship y'all got. You dig what I'm saying? Because look, a motherfucker can fake on that one-on-one monogamy shit.
Mm-hmm.
Motherfucker can't fake. When you start adding too many people to the situation.
Right.
You dig what I'm saying? Motherfuckers is real and raw.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know.
That's a fact.
But these other people, they can't even do a monogamous relationship. They ain't got something to say about something we doing.
You can't do nothing. The world news, nigga. This nigga world news. I got a lady that was really victimized by world news and abused.
Mm.
And she had a miscarriage.
Mm.
And was in the hospital bleeding for days.
Wow.
And it's hard for me to get it out of her, but she says she's gonna be ready to open up about me, what happened, and if I could show it to the public. I wanna tag her Instagram and everything. Cause this is crazy how this nigga got the nerve to talk about somebody when his wife kicked him out and he was sleeping in the garage.
Deep.
This bum ass nigga.
Deep.
He probably still living in the garage right now.
Deep.
Cause he was sending new pics to another woman. His wife found out. It's mad shit with this nigga, man. He got the nerve. He can't talk. After this interview Monday, Mommy Rose gonna do a promotion video as well. After this interview Monday, Surviving World News is real.
Mm-hmm.
For Spanish and English.
Mm-hmm.
It's just gonna be a big thing. Like, no man is gonna get away with, and people gonna listen to a nigga that hit a pregnant woman with her kid, send it to the hospital.